We'll see about the NFS setup. NFS is network file system. So you have a server where you store all the files, and say you want to access those files by logging into any other machines. So you share those files using NFS. So NFS file system does what it does is, as it says, it is a client server system that allows users to access files across the network, and it treats them as the local files. So user will not know that the file they are accessing is actually on the server. They will think that it is on their local machine. So for the sake of this example, there are two machines provided to each everybody. One is the NFS server and another will be the NFS client. So for this demonstration, OSL4, this machine will be used as NFS server, and OSL5 will be used as NFS client. So who are working on the servers, follow these steps. The dep packages are stored at this URL. The last three are the dep packages for installing NFS. You download them in your home directory. Then in OSL4, run these commands. These are the package names. So you have to give the path where these packages are stored. Most of you have stored these packages in the home directory. Just these commands will be enough. This dpkg command will install the dep packages. So copy paste this command in the terminal. You have to give the path where it is stored. In the handouts, the command is given. So go to the path and do port map, write port and click tab. So it will complete the name. You don't have to write the complete name manually. So first package to be installed is the port map. Press enter. So we'll use apt-get to install the required packages for NFS. You go to this URL. After going here, download this sources.lst file. Right click, save link as, save it in your home directory. After you do that, open a terminal, that is applications, accessories, terminal. We have to copy the sources.list file that we have just downloaded. So cp is the copy command. As you give the path of sources.lst, as we have saved it in the home directory, I am giving sources.list. It should be copied to /etc/apt/sources.list. Use sudo. For both server and client should follow this procedure. After copying this file, we have to update the repositories. So use apt-get update command. it will update the repository. Open a terminal, go to Applications, Accessories, Terminal. You will get this screen. Go to Super User Mode using SU, Enter. Password is reset to root123. Root password is set to root123. After that, for server installation, we have to install some packages. The packages in Linux are installed with this command, apt-get install, and then the package name. So here we are installing three packages for NFS server. One is NFS kernel server, second is NFS common, and third is portmap. So write these commands as it is. Press enter. It might ask for yes no confirmation. Press Y and press enter. There are three packages. It has to be written space separated. Portmap is one, nfs-common is second, and nfs-kernel-server is third. Next thing is, what we have to do is, we have to create a file in server, and that has to be ultimately shared using NFS with the client. So we have basic purpose for our servers now is, we have to create a directory, and in that directory we will create a one file. So as you see in the slide, we will create a directory called /extra/dir. So for that, write mkdir /extra/dir. By the way, who is running server should do this thing. The one with the server machine. There is client server pair. So one should install client and one should install server. So the server machine should do this thing. So make dir space /extra/dir. Now for the server machines, see what is your IP. So for that, run ifconfig command. Ifconfig, press enter. You will see your IP here. Note down this IP. Only fourth octet is you have to note down. First three are same: 10.105.11.xyz. Okay. After noting down this IP, you create you go to this file using cd /extra/dir. Press enter. So you have shifted to this directory now. Create a file using vim. So vim, some name, say abc, enter. Press I so that you can write in this file. Write something, some word, say Nishant. To close this file, press escape, shift colon, WQ. Now this is the file we want to share on all the clients which we will install in future. So after creating this file, open one more file, vim /etc/exports. It will open one file. Press I to insert into the file. Open /etc/exports file with using vim. So open this file. Press I to write into this file. Then see the handouts. You have to enter the first entry, this entry into the file. Only the IP is to be changed. So write slash extra slash dir space your IP address that you got from if config command. So my machine is acting as a server, so I am writing 10.105.11.251. remember, these commands are to be done on the server side only. Okay, since you are using different machine, let me restate my statements. After opening this on client machine, run ifconfig command on terminal. And note down the client's IP. And this thing is to be written in the exports file. Let me state again, in the slash on the server side, in slash etc slash exports, you have to write client's IP. What this statement means is, this directory is to be shared on this client machine using read write permissions. So let me restate. On server side, in slash etc slash exports file, you have to write client's IP address. Yeah, on server side, in that file, you have to write client's IP address. Is everybody done with it? Okay, next thing. So here, understand, you have created this directory on server side and you have given permission to this machine, that is client machine, to have read write permission to whatever is there in that directory. This is the meaning of this complete line. Come out of the file. Then you have to start a service. It is given in the handout. Slash etc slash init.d slash nfs kernel server restart. Nothing is to be done in the client side till now. Client will not do anything for now. The services will start. Giving message OK. So I hope you have run this command to start the NFS server. Next thing to do is run the last command, export FS. Export FS minus RA. After this, you have enabled the access for the client machine to read and write the files in the server. So now we have to set up the client. So server side is done. Now client machines will follow the next procedure. I will log in to the client. I had specified this IP as the client, so I am logging in there to set up the client side. You don't need to do this. In the next slide of handout, you will see these commands. This is for NFS client installation. So run the first command, apt-get install, NFS common, and port map. This is to be done on the client side. After that, the packages will be installed. You now have to create one more directory in the client side, mkdir/root/temp. You go to this directory with cd/root/temp and do ls. You will find that there is no file. We have just created the directory, and after doing ls, there is no file in that directory. Now we run the third command. This mount command will mount the directory. So what this command will do is, it will mount this directory which we have created on the server side. So this is the server IP address. So this directory from this server will be mounted at this place on the client side. This command is to be run at the client side, and the IP address given here should be of the server side, because we are mounting this directory from server at this client path. Press enter. Now do ls. You will find that previously there was no file in the /root/temp directory. Now the file which was created on the server, this ABC, will be listed on the client side. You can open this file from the client side and see the content. The file still resides in the at the server side, but client doesn't know. Client thinks that it is in his local file system, that is /root/temp. But in reality, we have just mounted the file from the server at the client side. Now open the file again from the client side. Make some changes in the file. Press I. Write something else in the file. Save it using escape shift colon WQ. Now go to the server side. Open the file at the server side. And you will see the changes reflected back at the server side also. So come out of this file now. As we have mounted this file system using mount command at the client side, so after we restart the client, this changes will not be reflected. So to make the changes permanent, so that after each reboot of the client, this file system to be mounted on the client side, you need to change the fstab file. The file is /etc/fstab. Open this file on the client side. /etc/fstab. It will list the currently mounted file systems. So at the end, you can write one more line that is given in the handout. If you write this line in the FS tab of your client machine, after each reboot of the client, these changes will be made, and you will see the changes permanent. So here, server side IP is to be given, so that it will mount the server side directory in the client's this directory. And after each reboot, you don't have to run the mount command again and again. We will not do that actually, because it requires rebooting the system and see this thing. So what we have done is now we have installed a NFS server and we have created a directory. In that directory we have created a file. We have installed a NFS client on another machine. This NFS client is used to mount the directory from the server side to the client side. We have seen the changes that was done in the server side reflected back at the client side. And as we have shared this directory in read-write mode, the client side, the changes which client makes are reflected back at the server side also. So this is the NFS setup.